How are we doing, folks? It's raining. Well, I found this, well, me and Chris found this really cool tunnel system. I think it's 1860 in date, and massive long corridors down there and stuff like that. But check this out. This is a serious little fort hidden in the hills.
Grain Fort is a former artillery fort located just east of the village of Grain. It was constructed in the 1860s to defend the River Medway and the Thames during the period of tension with France. It was repeatedly altered and its guns upgraded at various times throughout its history, before being decommissioned in 1956 when the UK abolished its coastal defence programme. It was subsequently demolished and the remnants of the fort buried. But today, we can see the remains of the underground tunnels that still lie beneath your feet.
Secret fort in the hills, folks. Where the hell is it? This is crazy.
Here we go.
There's just fawns everywhere.
You think this doesn't just cover on the outside?
No, no, we're in the moat, we're in the moat.
Yeah.
Just a lot, so you can see where, you know, people have been going over there. Jesus. Well, what can I say, folks? This is possibly the magazine area of Grain Battery. Didn't know we was going to find this. Off chance. You alright, Chris? Let us know.
Yeah.
Got to try and keep things still. Moisture down here. Oh, you can feel that on your skin. You got the drone, yeah?
Yeah.
Is this the original floor?
If you look at this. Possibly all broken up bits.
Yeah, because it's... What size is this?
Hello? Look, a massive boiler.
Right.
Wow. It just goes on and on. Let's have a look down here first.
That end's bricked up then. Straight in front of you.
Yeah.
They've just knocked through it.
Oops, sorry.
God, look at the backfill there.
Jesus.
Come on.
So this is possibly the fort inside there that they filled in the central part. It's another door there. It's criminal what they've done, really. This could have been open to the public. Oh, wow. Firing slits. That's interesting.
See, it's all been bricked up before it's been backfilled, though, isn't it?
Yeah, preserved, I suppose, that way. You notice the walls are all normal sandy coloured bricks.
Yeah.
Hasn't been painted. All parts have, like in here. Like the Western Heights ones. You alright? Let us know if you can't see, mate.
Oh.
Look at the partition thing here. Quite interesting.
I like the shape of the brickwork.
Yeah. It's interesting. Right, here we go. Secret fort hidden in the hills. Just making sure that's not a hole down to a lower level, folks. It's quite squishy around there. It's massive, isn't it? Chat, you alright?
Yeah, no, you alright.
Yeah, it's no, mate. No weapons. Oh, that's it. This is not what I was thinking of.
What's up there in the hole? Have a look.
Nothing. Backfill. Mud.
Okie dokie.
So this is part. This is not the main one that I thought it was. But this is certainly interesting to see this. Definitely worth getting muddy crawling into this place. A lot of mosquitoes around as well. How are you doing, folks? So that was the one entrance we've been spinning. We've been to the fort that way, and now we're going to go into another one, into the best part. It's got the big magazine and stuff like that, for the main magazine for the whole fort. So let's check this out. Hope this is worth it. Oh, sorry. Ow! That's a big. Hey. Right, this is the second tunnel section we found. Another open one. What have we got here? Is it deep?
It's full of water.
Takes your weight, it's going to take mine, isn't it?
I was more concerned about, obviously, I'll go and test it. You're sending me to test it out completely all dry.
Just so I can get in that one. Oh, watch what you're stepping in. There's the old ventilation in there. Magazines. That's in the magazine again. Oh, whoa.
Oh, wow.
That is
still got the handle.
Yeah. That is the what's it called for the ammo hoist? Winch it up.
That's the second hoist of the day.
Yeah, definitely. It's a bit bigger this one, I think, with the.
Go and look up it.
Oh, yeah, it goes up quite far. Got the chain on it as well there. Full of water down there. Goes up to just mud. That's one of those things. See that in the cliff fort? It's got them. I think that just goes to a dead end, you know. The two either side, the gun rooms either side down there. Right. Whoa, look at that. That's the lamp room, isn't it? That's what people are on about.
Is it?
Quite rare. There's people that took pictures of them sitting in it.
Oh, right. Looks familiar, but... Wow.
This is the main magazine, then. One of them. I don't know if there's any more. That's big, folks. That is serious. Go and stand in the corner a minute, Chris, if you don't mind. You see all that mud there in front of us here? That's come through that tiny little hole there from there where they're filling the fort up. This is completely buried. You see the size of it with Chris standing over there. Crazy. Right, let's go to that other bit quickly, see what's down there. So that's the main magazine of the fort. That is that light, that's where they put the lights in a passage like that. Light up the room and the magazine. That's amazing. Right. Sort of rushing a tiny bit, folks, because my main light has come on with a red light saying that it's going to go flat. And I don't really want to be filming with this torch only. Oh, got another drawbridge.
And it collapsed.
Alright, is that safe?
Yeah.
That's alright then.
Over you go then.
Wow, look at this. That is some serious concrete blocks.
Little pram.
Yeah, at least it's shut down here. Go and climb over there, mate. Let's film it.
You can't really get any further.
No, is there any interesting features there?
I think they filled it. I think that is from concrete.
So it looks like they have demolished parts of the actual fort and just chucked it through the entrances.
Yeah, because it's that.
Criminals.
That's concrete.
Yeah. Let's go up there. This old pram. Cool, look at this. Cement looks fresh. That cement is weird, isn't it?
But that end,
it's got to be close to the entrance that flies rear. Mm. It's possibly open at some point and they've sealed it up again, this side. Mm. Up through that little opening there.
Look, they've sealed it up with wood, and when they poured the concrete down here.
Look, like that grate is there,
yeah.
In front of that hole in the concrete.
Yeah.
That's looking bad.
It's a shame though, isn't it?
It is a big shame. It was a magnificent fort. In its heyday. But there you go.
Yeah, so these are the main drawbridges. But, so yeah, that's the outside of the fort. And that was the way in. And these drawbridges are the actual, this is where we've been pulled up in the event of invasion of the fort. Look at that grill thing above that, though. It's good, isn't it? I actually do prefer this than the ones in Dover.
Yeah.
For some reason. The other ones in Dover still got the drawbridges still in place. Pull the drawbridge up using a bit of rope or chain. And so it probably is rope tight around that so the door will be flat. Boom. Locking you in and locking the enemy out. Amazing. Is this the passage for the ventilation? Oh, whoa!
Cool.
Ventilation either side there. What the? That's crazy. Oh, it's a light passage for the magazine. There it is, folks.
That would have had the back of that was.
Yeah, it would have had glass in there. And that this lamp would have lit the main magazine up. Which is in there, folks. Crazy, that is crazy. It's the biggest magazine I've ever seen, actually. It's like the water tanks in the north entrance.
Oh.
Here, I'll let you come up, mate. I can't get past you. Oh, God, watch your head. Oh.
Well, that was it. That was the hidden fort in the hills. What an amazing journey. I've never been in there before. That was the first time for me. And yeah, unfortunately my torch ran out halfway, at the end of the video, there was nothing else to see really. So I ended it there. There's nothing really to see. So, yeah, so fantastic to see that. So thanks very much for watching, folks. Check out the Facebook, Instagram, all that jazz. Thanks for your support. I'll see you again soon, folks. Cheerio.
So fuel for the planes would have been stored underneath this room in a bunker, bomb-proof bunker. And you must be wondering, where are the fuel tanks?
Documenting stuff, I don't want to be smelling fire. You know, you do get idiots about that set fire to old buildings and stuff like that. I do not want to be around if people are doing that. So what do you reckon on this site then?
I think it's actually quite scary, to be honest with you. It's a bit creepy. Comparing it to Canterbury, when we went there, to the psychiatric hospital.